Hi, my name is Yantai Furi, this is Michael, and welcome to my gym. Today we'll be doing 5 exercises, including the push-up, squat, single leg, Romanian deadlift, bend over row, and the plank. We'll also do some warm-up exercises, followed by some cool-down stretches. Let's start with a warm-up exercise. Today we're going to be doing jumping jacks. Let me show you how to do some. You can now do some jumping jacks till failure, and that way it will warm up all your muscles. Okay. We are now going to start with our first exercise, the push-up. The safety of the push-ups. Hands must be slightly wider than your shoulders. Core must be tight throughout the entire movement. Back must not arch, and elbows must not lock at the top. The movement of the push-up. You must get down on all fours, arms slightly wider than your shoulders, straighten arms and legs, lay yourself till your chest almost hits the ground, back up to original position. The muscles used in the push-up, the chest, pectoralis major and minor, the shoulder muscles, the deltoid, upper arms, bicep and tricep. The back muscles used is the latissimus dorsi, the rhomboid major and minor, and the trapezius. The joints used in the push-up is the shoulder joint, which is a ball and socket joint, the elbow joint, which is a hinge joint, and the wrist joint, which is a condyloid joint. During the downward phase of the push-up, by bending the elbows, the action starts laying you to the ground. Once your elbows are flexed, shoulder blades are ducked, squeezing them together to complete the action. The upward phase of the push-up. You now must lift yourself. Pectoralis major is the main mover as you abduct your shoulder blades. Elbows extension is caused by the tricep. The adapters we can do for a push-up, for example, the knee push-up. The second adaption, we can put a towel around the client's waist, and as he comes up, you can help him. The safety of the squat. Feet and knees must be facing forward at all times. Feet flat on the floor also at all times. Keep hips and feet aligned. The movement of the squat. Lay yourself down, facing forward as if you will be sitting on a chair. Keep your back straight and squeeze your glutes, and then return to starting position. The muscles used in the squat. The glute muscles, the gluteus maximus, medius and minimus. For the upper leg, the abductor magnus, vastus lateralis and medialis, rectus femoris, bicep femoris, and for the lower leg, gastrocnemius and the soleus. The joints used in the squat. The hip joint, which is a ball and socket joint. The knee joint, which is a hinge joint. And the ankle joint, which is also a hinge joint. During the downward phase of the squat, bending the knee, quad tricep muscles will be contracted eccentrically. The upward phase of the squat. There is extension at the hip, brought about the concentric contraction of the glute maximus. At the same time, there is extension at the knee due to concentric contraction in the quad tricep. The ankle goes through plantar flexion. The spotting area of the squat. You can also climb by the rib cage. And the adaption of the squat. You can use dumbbells to make the exercise harder. The next exercise is the single leg Romanian deadlift. The safety of this exercise. Don't lock supporting knee. You must keep your abs engaged at all times. The movement of this exercise. Stand with feet shoulder width apart, with knees slightly bent. raise the leg off the floor till it's nearly in line with your stomach. Bend at the hips till your torso is parallel with the floor. Pause at the bottom, squeeze your glute, and then go back to starting position. The muscles used in this exercise: the bicep femoris, the semimembranosus, semi-endinosus, and the muscles of the glutes, which is the glutes maximus, minimus, and medius, the antagonist muscles, the rectus abdominis, the obliques, and the trapezius. The joints used is the hip joint, which is a ball and soccer joint. I'm now going to show you an example of the single leg Romanian deadlift. So your hips and feet aligned, and the supporting knee must not lock, must be slightly bent. And now my client's going to do this exercise. Knee must not lock. Getting the downward face, there is hip flexion, eccentric muscle contraction, and the muscles lengthen as they contract. The upward face, hip extension, concentric muscle contraction, as the muscles shorten as they contract. The spotting and adaption, the client can hold on to me for stability. The next exercise is the bent over row. The safety of the exercise: back must not arch, your chest must be up. Don't overload with weight in order to keep your form. The movement of this exercise: hold dumbbells with an overhand grip, hands should be wider than your shoulders. Bend over, pull the bar or dumbbell up towards the middle of your stomach and lower till fully extended. The muscles used: the middle and lower trapezium, the rhomboid muscle, latissimus dorsi, the teres major and minor muscle, the infraspinatus. Antagonist muscles used is the pectoralis major, posterior deltoid, bronchialis, bicep femoris, the long head of the tricep, and the erector spine muscle. The joints used is the shoulder joint, which is a ball and soccer joint, and the elbow, which is a hinge joint. Okay, and now I will be giving an example of this exercise. I will now ask my client to do this exercise. The action of this exercise: the upward face is an eccentric muscle contraction. At the shoulder, the latissimus dorsi and the posterior deltoid muscle. At the scapula, the trapezius and the rhomboid muscle cause contraction. At the elbow and the bicep branchi cause extension. The inward face is a concentric muscle contraction. The last exercise for the day will be plank. The safety of the plank: keep your body in a straight line, don't arch your back or tilt your head up. The movement of the plank: you must begin in a planking position, straighten your body, toes on the floor, elbows directly under your shoulders. The muscles used in the plank: the rectus abdominis, the internal obliques, transversus abdominis, and the antagonist muscles used is the trapezius, the rhomboid, minor and major, the bicep branchi, tricep, latissimus dorsi, pectoralis muscle, the deltoid and the glutes. The joints used in the plank will be the shoulder, which is a ball and soccer joint, and the hip, which is also a ball and soccer joint. I will now give an example of the plank. And now I will ask my client to do a plank. must lower your back. Engage your core. You can assist your client by putting a towel under his belly button and assisting him. The adaptations I can give to my client is a straight arm plank as following. For cool down exercises, you can do the following stretches. For example, toe touches for 20 seconds. You can also do the neck stretch. Thank you for watching the video.